That's him. You tell him.
Yeah, listen, man. E-bikes are cheating.
Go fuck yourself.
Oh, okay.
Welcome to MTV Chronicle Studio. We've had a lot of requests from people to see the studio and to do some product reviews and hacks, and that's exactly what we're doing today. So this is a video I didn't want to make, but I have to make it. So, have you ever been e-shamed? Yeah. You roll your eyes at the unsolicited e-bikes are cheating. They want you to know that they're on a legacy bike. It's a form of virtue signaling.
Hi everyone, it's Dr. Romani, and today we're gonna talk about narcissists and virtue signaling. It's really kind of a gross one, so hang on to your hats.
But little does he realize you don't give a flying arse about his opinion. Here at MTV Chronicles, we don't virtue signal. Tell him to.
Hey! Shut the fuck up!
To be honest, no decent rider ever said anything negative. It's only ever been wannabes and posers. So.
Shut the fuck up, bitch!
And when I hear someone give his unsolicited opinion, e-bikes are cheating. Ah, I'll get one when I can't ride a normal one. I think.
Shut up, do you know how dumb you sound?
Sam Pilgrim? Remy Mattei, Greg Callahan, Tanny Seagrave, Danny McCaskill, Josh Briceland, Tommy C. Hype, Mark Byrne, and Rachel Atherton. Why would anyone care what you think?
Motherfucker, what makes you think I care? Shut the fuck up!
And they'll continue to diss e-bikes until they decide to get one. Until they decide to get one. Then it'll be okay. And they will get one. Everyone will. I've told you that before. And then they'll sing the praises of e-bikes like they aren't a hypocrite. I've never heard any mountain biker who has an e-bike regret getting one. The only people, it seems, who diss them are people who ain't got one yet.
So I'll get right to the point. Shut the fuck up. Nobody wants to hear it. Nobody will ever want to hear it. Nobody cares. And the fact that you thought someone might care is honestly baffling to me.
In reality, they are the future of MTV. If you don't think so, you might be deluded. Now, I'm not saying e-bikes are better than legacy bikes, but they're definitely more fun. And I dare say, to further what Rob Warner has said, e-bikes are more of a mountain bike than a mountain bike is.
So?
This is what you're doing. This is what I want you to do. Any questions?
Did you just tell me to shut up?
Yeah.
We've got some really cool stuff to do, and we're going to be doing a review of this little gadget here. Well cool. Okay. But what we're going to do, we're going to start off with this hack for a Garmin out front mount. This is the Edge extended out front bike mount for mountain bikes. So there's longer ones that are sort of made for road, and there's these nice short ones. So it's designed, it goes on the bar like that, and that's out front. But today what we're going to do is we're going to remove this insert, we're going to take it out, we're going to turn the bracket upside down, and we're going to mount it back on upside down. Okay. You brought your spacer, didn't you? Okay, so it's come off. So now we're just going to turn it upside down.
and mount this back on here, and it will be facing forward like this, and you mount the screws in from the original spot where the bracket was. So one button in the punch and the other. So that's that one in, and that's the second one in, nice and tight. Yeah, so as I was saying, this is going on to Marie's bike. We're going to take off the Garmin Hack version 1.0. This is the Garmin Hack version 2.0. And this is a much better setup. And most of you guys out there who have Garmins probably have one of these brackets. And they're not really fashionable to use on mountain bikes with the bracket out front. But the way we're making this, it suits mountain bikes so much. Really good. Okay, so we're taking off this version 1.0 because I've come up with a much better idea. So you saw what I did with the mount. Now we're going to take this off. So to do that on a Specialized, you have to remove the headset clamping mechanism from down here. So as I said, we're getting rid of this mount. You'll see it a bit more clearly now when I take off this stem after I. Okay, so here's the modified Garmin mount. The mount remounted on the top of it, sorry, on the bottom. And now the mount itself is turned upside down. We use one of the shims for mounting it onto 31.5 bars. Okay. Now, if you want to do this hack and you're using a Garmin out front mount, this is the road one. This is longer, and this is going to look goofy if you try and use this. So what you want to look out for is the shorter one, and you'll know the shorter one by these sort of four grooves here. There's four right there. But basically, the other important one, how you can tell the difference is, on this one, when it's mounted the correct way and it's facing out, the Garmin logo will be facing directly up. On this one, this is the road one, the Garmin logo is facing on the side. So that's how you know this is the longer one. And I'll show it to you back to back here. I'll turn this one upside down. You can see it's a fair bit longer. You know, it's a fair bit longer. I'd say it's a good maybe 10 mil, 15 mil longer. And it's just going to make it look a bit goofy. And that will be in your way, but that one won't. Okay, next what we have for review is this baby right here. It's a Fumpa. This is an electronic pump. Here's the unboxing. Take it out. Fits in the palm of your hand. Fits in your hand. Fits in the corner of your backpack. Right, let's see this baby in action. So we have, this tire is flat. This tire is quite flat. So what we're going to do is, we have the valve open, and we're going to turn on. We're going to engage it onto the valve, and now we're going to press the button.
Let's
16 PSI with no effort. Let's try it. Yes, I like that. And that was effortless. Now, to all you naysayers of e-bikes, is this cheating or not? Is this cheating? Probably so. Well, you might need to move, so I can see ahead anyway. This ghetto tubeless tire inflator made out of a fire extinguisher that you don't need anymore. Okay. I drilled a 6mm hole here. I put in a tubeless valve. I wrapped some plumber's tape around the inside of the tubeless valve as I was sitting through to help with sealing. If you're going to do this, just hit this part here with a hammer anti-clockwise. This part here will just screw off. You're going to have to use a gear cable going down the center of this, and you're going to have to sort of tie it and hook it so that when you're putting this in, it's the only way you can put it in. So you thread it through the valve, push it all through there, and you have the other end of the wire coming up here, and you just pull it up and out pops your valve. So you can then just hold the valve with your finger and then pull the cable back out of the valve, and then you'll be able to screw on your lock nut to hold your valve in place. This rubber tubing here is basically off an old track pump I had, and believe it or not, I actually threaded this rubber hose straight onto the treads inside this. I threaded it in. It was quite hard to do, but I threaded it in, and then when I had it in all the way, I filled the gap there with super glue. So that's that. And then I actually put in a bit of tubeless tire and sealant inside this to help seal any small little tiny gaps or where there's air escaping, and done the job. Doesn't lose any air now. So we're going to show you. This tire here, we'll let the air out of it again. Okay, so we're putting air into the fire extinguisher, and then we are going to pump up this tire, which is totally flat. Now, I've already tried this on a tire that I had to reinstall onto a rim because I had to replace sealant, and it works a dream. This is real easy to do. I thought it sounded like a lot of hassle to do this conversion, but it was super easy. It was way easier than I thought it'd be, as long as you have all the bits and pieces. If you have an old track pump lying around, if you have an old fire extinguisher lying around, you have more than you need. You have everything you need. So I'm gonna pump this up to 80 PSI. And we're at 80 right there. If you have it and you have the end of your track pump still on the tube, if you have one of these heads, you could leave it on the end of the tube. But the head I had, it was old and it was fucked. didn't work at all, so I'm just using the bare tube. I am probably going to add a track pump head onto this, but just like this, and even with the valve core still in, it works. So this will fit super snug over that valve right there like that. Now it is super snug, but I will hold it. Now look here. So pull out your grenade pin, get ready with this, and focus on the tire there. Okay, you ready? And we're pulling the trigger now. Let go. Bit more. Okay, that's well heard now. So I'm gonna let that go and take that off. Now, let's do a pressure reading. Right, so that was, as you saw, it's totally deflated tire. We got 0 PSI there, and we got 18 PSI there. Let's see if we can get a bit more in. See, when you inflate it fully, the pressure then equalizes between this and this, because when you have that trigger fully open, when the air goes in and pressurizes this, it then all equals itself out. So the PSI in this and the PSI in this are going to be the exact same. So let's see what we got here. 20 PSI. Well enough to seat your rim, to seat your tire on the rim of a tubeless tire.
Fucking
cheater.
Fucking
loader bikes.
I want one.
Yeah,
they're only for
benders. How dare you?
Oh, there's just one other thing I should say. We have lots of requests to do a review on these gloves, but they're not politically correct. Where are those not politically correct gloves? Yeah. So these gloves are not politically correct, because you know, I don't want to be chucked off YouTube, because I don't want to get cancelled. Okay, this is a really cool bike stand, so just buy two of these. Okay, mount them together like that using a bit of wood and bolts, and the good thing about this is you can fold this almost to non-existent flat and just put it in the boot or wherever you want to put it under seats. But if you have a car like mine or you have a van, this is perfect, and it will carry two bikes, or it'll carry one bike, and the bike will be stable in the van. So I'm going to show you that now. Okay, and if you have a van or a car like mine, the stand is inside the car or the van, and you can just roll your bike in. This is a 29er as well, and it just sits there. Turn the front wheel and it's solid, it's not going anywhere. Even if there's no bike in the second part, it's not going anywhere. Take it from the back. So it takes two bikes. You don't have to have the wheels turned. If the other bike is in it, I would just leave the handlebar straight. But with one bike only, I turn the handlebar so it's just more stable, and as is, it doesn't wobble, doesn't fall over, and it's just so handy. Bosh.
On an e-bike, very leisurely pace and output of energy. Do that. Get hammered up, gap, pedal up on the EB
hammered up it, and my camera wasn't recording. I had to delete some footage. But man, I was gasping when I got up here. So let's see what sort of result we can fast forward to after I've uploaded the ride. And here is E gap pedal up, and that effort right there landed me with a 413 third spot. So let's go into the leaderboard, and Thomas with a 404, Silver Mask with a 405, Derek Whelan 413, me with 413. So go on, go ahead and get an e-bike and match that time, or beat that time, and then you will see that you do put in work. But Thomas, you better watch out. Match that time or beat that time. See what sort of work you have to put in, even on an e-bike. So grab yourself an e-bike, go and do that trail there, hammer it. Match that time or beat that time. Otherwise,
shut the fuck up.
Jesus. Man, my fucking left knee just gives way sometimes. Fucking hell, man. It's not a nice feeling. Evo today. Going uphill at Eurosceptic. And this going up this hill is not unpleasant. Tell you one thing though, I'm feeling it. I've hit the gym the other night, as in my own home gym. Fucking body is aching, shoulders, arms, and this is the Knievo. It's a good bit heavier than the Levo. This gives you an upper body workout. You'll feel it, but still fun. Like I'm breathing hard, man, but the climb is still fun. So what I'm on right now, this is a chairlift. This is a ski lift. This is a gondola for countries that don't have one. And look at this one. It's actually fun going up this hill. So whenever I hear anyone who doesn't even have an e-bike trying to diss them, I dismiss their remark. out of hand. Exclusive unboxing video right now. This soup in the gap. There's the packaging. And it comes with the usual paper, a couple of bits of salt, and one of these. This is serious unboxing now, look. Beautiful bread in there. And a little single portion of butter. The bread is warm, so the butters are ready to spread on the bread. Now, this soup here, I had it for the first time 2 days ago. Well, it was the most time, I like it. But that's the, Marie got the veg. This is the veg one. Smells nice. It's quality. Can I get here and show this one here? Oh yeah, man, look at that. Look at that. I'm gonna tip you over here a bit. Look at that. And I'm telling you, this soup is delicious. I was really impressed with the soup, and I'm gonna get it from now on when I come to the gap. I'm gonna get this soup or whatever other flavors of soup that they have. Drink it, whatever you want. Do you eat soup or drink it? Answer in the comments below if you like mushrooms or if Marie is right. The gap is just fucking amazing. Look at it. Look at this place, man. It's like... awesome. I like the way you can eat. You don't even move up to it.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
They could do skydiving here. This field, this area here is big enough to land it. You'd see Mark coming down every Sunday, landing and then hopping on his bike.
Or he'll land on the bike.
It's bearable sitting up here in the middle of the mountains. Actually, Johnny Fox's is just over there. The highest pub in Ireland. Well, it's the emptiest pub in Ireland now. Yeah, roll on to summer. It's hot, never end.
Summer's going quick, considering.
I know, yeah. By about the end of August, I was out on the bike. That's fucking insane. I would need to be an octopus now to manage this job. I need to hold the camera, the handlebar, my drink without spilling any, and the rubbish. Okay. Well, he's getting the rubbish. Come on, here she is.
Just tell me to shut up.
Yes.